We have discussed that how we can transform and how we can clone into an E. coli. So we know we can use plasmids and we know we can use bacteriophages. We have discussed bacteriophage lambda until now, but this new phage is M13. It's a filamentous bacteriophage and it is composed of circular single-stranded DNA, which is only 6.4 base pairs long. Now, what is the advantage of this small size? Again, it is very attractive for cloning because its transformation efficiency is very high. As it is a filamentous phage, it doesn't have a head and a body tail. And there are few other differences as well between bacteriophage lambda structure and an M13. Its capsid is composed of 2,700 copies of a protein known as P8, and which is capped with 5 copies of 2 different minor code proteins, P9, P6 and P3. In comparison, lambda, which structure looks very sophisticated, it has only 15 different proteins making the head and tail structure. Now, let's look at how this particular phage looks like. You can appreciate the complexity when you can see this P3, P8 making its body. It is composed of several subunits. It means that its assembly would be very, very interesting and very complex. This purple color basically tells you about the single-stranded DNA. This is its head composed of P7 subunits. And this is the area which you can call a tail. And through this particular area, it attaches itself to a bacteria and insert its single-stranded DNA. Now, if we look at how this insertion happens. So, we know that bacteria uses pili for conjugation. But in this particular system, the pili is formed, but M13 uses that to inject its DNA, which is a single-stranded DNA. But ultimately, to go into and form a DNA replicative form, it becomes double-stranded. And in this particular condition, it replicates independently over 100 times. When I say independently, then again, bacteria is not divided, but within one bacteria, within that 20 minutes or even longer, which is going to take it to divide, it is going to independently replicate 100 times. And the minor code protein, basically P3, attaches to the receptor at the tip of F. pylus of the host, which is E. coli in this case. Infection with filamentous phages is not lethal. Now, one of my friends always used to say that M13 phage is pretty much like your wives. They don't really kill you, but they get what they want. And with M13 is able to make a lot of its copies and ultimately keep producing more M13 phages, but it doesn't kill E. coli and it's still able to make turbid plaques. I'll come to the plague point later. You can see in this image that how rolling circle mechanism takes place to produce single-stranded DNA, and from double-stranded we again have this transformation where a single strand is being produced and that single strand is being packaged into host cells. So hum yaha kya dekh rahe hain ki ek taraf to jis tarah ek sada plasmid ultimately replicate kar raha hota hai, isi tarike se aapke paas kafi sari formation ho gayi. Maslan, in this particular image you can see it's continuously being formed, lekin dusri taraf again, it is being converted into circular single-stranded DNA, which is being packaged into mature phage particles. In this way, phage makes a very, very smart move and divides itself. So, when each daughter cell divides, we get about 1,000 new phages, which is amazing. And this particular vector system was developed to basically form single stranded DNA for sequencing alongside with PUC series. Now we have very fancy pore mechanisms and various fluorescent mechanisms to basically sequence DNA, but initially The vectors used were M13 and PUC. Now, when true plaques are formed, produced by cell lysis, by the lambda, when lambda, bacteriophage lambda is cloned, we get true plaques. What are plaques? And plaques are basically, if you have a bacterial lawn, then there are zone of clearance which is formed. And in that particular zone, because lambda is lytic, therefore we get this zone of clearance. But on M13, this zone of clearance cannot be produced because it's not lytic. But E. coli is growing so slow that we get this idea that there is a zone of clearance, but actually it's not. Let me explain that to you in a bit better way. So in this particular image, what you can see is a lawn of bacterial growth. And this particular white spots are that zone of clearance where lambda is dividing. As you can see in this picture, that this dark brown shade is where bacteria is growing, while these zones are where lambda is continuously infecting the cells and analyzing them. In M13 plaques, you don't have actually any lysis activity, but bacteria is growing so slow that you get virtually some zone of clearance. In our next topic, we'll see that how we can ultimately modify the M13 genome, which is very small in size, for our benefit and to clone our genes of interest.